Hello, Mrs. Michaels. You remember me, don't you? We met at Playland. I got some news for you about your husband.
Where is he?
You mind if I come in? What I've got to talk about is between you and me, and not the entire neighborhood.
Is Kirk all right? Just tell me that.
Oh, calm down. Your husband's just fine for now.
I want to see for myself. Why didn't he come with you? When is he coming home?
That all depends. Right now, Kirk's real busy rapping with another buddy of ours. Who knows how long it'll take for him to get caught up in old times.
Kirk doesn't remember any old times. He doesn't know you. He never did. I told you that. Now, why won't you believe me?
No, you and Kirk sure got your stories straight. No, he heard all about his bad memory. It's like a broken record.
I swear to you, it's the truth.
No sale, doll. Kirk wouldn't forget what we want to know. No way.
What are you talking about?
10 years ago, Kirk and me and my pal transacted some business that was supposed to be very profitable. Biggest payday of our lives. Only Kirk got a little greedy and he skipped out on us. We haven't seen him or the money since.
Kirk wouldn't know anything about that.
He's into us for $50,000, not including interest. And we intend to collect.
Even if he wanted to, he couldn't help you.
And how about you, Mrs. Michaels? Can you help me?
Me?
Well, you married the guy. Now, he must have told you where his money is.
I don't know anything about this.
Mrs. Michaels, unless your memory gets a whole lot better than Kirk's and real fast, something's going to happen to him. Now, you tell me where that money is. Or the next time that you see Kirk, it's going to be at his funeral.
What do I have to do to convince you that we're really telling the truth?
This is a real nice place you got here, Mrs. Michaels. You wouldn't have any objections if I just gave myself the grand tour, would you?
You think the money is here?
Well, I didn't think Kirk was dumb enough to hide it in your mattress. But it wouldn't surprise me a bit to find a safety deposit box key or a bank book tucked somewhere inside of a drawer.
Please, search the place. Turn it upside down if you want.
I just might do that. Think I'll start upstairs.
If I had had this many toys when I was a kid growing up, I wouldn't have bothered growing up.
I know what you mean, but even so, every day when I'm working in the kitchen or something, I feel this little tug at my knee, and it's Adam, and what do you say? You say, Mommy, I don't have anything to do.
No, no. Oh, well, getting Mommy's attention is much more fun than playing with toys.
Oh, you bet it is.
I have lots of toys.
Yes, you have lots of toys. But, you know, I wish I could spend more time with you. You've got a lucky mommy, though. She works in the evening, so she's working when you're asleep, when you're supposed to be asleep.
Shouldn't he be doing that just about now?
Yeah, he sure should.
If we don't go back downstairs, they're going to send up a search party for us.
That's right. Why don't you go down and tell Miles that we'll be right down, and Nancy and I will get things in order.
Okay. Good night, good fella.
Nicole, what is it? I don't see that sparkle you usually have.
It's just the same old thing I always worry about. I don't want Adam to be an only child, and I so much want to have Miles' baby.
I know. I know how much it means to you.
Well, we just took so long making that decision that every extra day seems like forever. I really didn't think there was going to be a problem.
Well, who says there is one, for goodness sake? Maybe it's psychological.
Yeah, I know. It could be that.
Yes, sometimes a person's attitude can have an effect on them physically. It's true.
Or maybe just Mother Nature is being a little bit coy with me. She could be just teasing me a little bit.
You never can tell.
In which case, cut it out.
Yeah. Have you seen a doctor?
Well, I saw a doctor a couple months ago when I thought I was pregnant. She just suggested that I have a complete physical.
Okay. Did you?
No. Well, Nancy, I don't really think that there's anything wrong with me.
Fine. Good. Have the physical, get a clean bill of health, and then you'll be in a good frame of mind. That could be just the answer.
I suppose you're right. Okay, I'll see the doctor. We better give him his goodnight kiss.
Mike, I didn't know you were downstairs.
The girls will be down in a minute.
All right, can I fix you a drink?
Please.
I was just taking the opportunity to clear off some of the trays so I'd get to eat all of my favorite canapes without Nicole watching, telling me to look out for my waistline.
I'm just as glad you took them away. Too much temptation. What happened to Jody and Kelly?
They went out to the garden a little while ago. I assume they're getting to know each other better.
I'm sure Kelly appreciates the opportunity. I think you know that he's taken quite a shine to Nicole's younger sister.
Mm. Well, I wish him luck. I'll say this much for him. He's got good taste in women, just like his uncle.
You like Jody, don't you?
Oh, sure, the little I know her. Seems to have a very bright mind inside that pretty head. And she knows exactly what she wants.
Hmm. Sounds like your family reunion is turning out all right. Wish I could say the same for ours.
Why? What's the matter?
There's more to Kelly than meets the eye. Even though he had a pretty decent childhood, he did have some disadvantages in the sense that he was forced to travel a lot because of his father's work.
And he's insecure?
Well, he shouldn't be. Lee and Jerry love him very much, and they've done all they can to make him feel wanted and protected.
But you still think there's a problem?
When it comes to discussing personal matters, Kelly automatically withdraws and goes into his shell.
Well, now, look, Mike, he hasn't been staying with you very long. Maybe in time he'll get more comfortable.
Maybe. But there's definitely a mystery about Kelly's life. His parents have admitted as much.
Well, didn't they tell you what it was?
Well, they feel that it should be Kelly's choice to tell us if he wants to.
Well, I'm sure he will then, sooner or later.
Whatever happened must have been fairly serious. We've deduced that the situation was the motivating factor in Kelly's choice to leave Rome and come to Monticello. And he's adamant about not going back, even to visit his parents.
Well, maybe he'll change his mind when he starts to miss them.
He told us in no uncertain terms that if they want to see him, they'll have to come here.
Well, this doesn't sound just like a family quarrel, then.
Oh, it wasn't a family quarrel. He told us that much. Miles, I don't know what happened in Rome, but whatever it was, it troubles Kelly deeply. And for the life of us, Nancy and I can't figure out why.
I wish I had made lunch and gym my favorite subjects in high school.
Well, you don't need to go to college if you're really sure you want to be a career dancer.
Yeah, but some universities offer great theater courses, with dancing as a specialty. If I only would have hit the books a little harder, I might have been offered a dance scholarship. Then I could have gotten a good education and concentrated on my dancing without all these financial hassles.
Well, live and learn, right?
Well, it's not that I'm complaining. It just would have been a lot easier.
Well, very few things in this world come wrapped in neat little packages.
You're telling me. God, I've had to fight and claw my way for the little I do have.
You're just paying your dues, that's all.
That's right. And you know, it doesn't matter because in a few years I'm going to know it was all worth it.
You know, if determination was all that you needed to get your name up on lights, you'd be a star already.
I'm going to make it, Kelly. And that's not just talk.
Well, then you ought to take Dr. Kavanaugh's advice and start taking better care of yourself.
I know, but I can't slow down. I've got to earn a living so I can take my dance lessons, and then there'll be food and rent.
Yeah, but I don't want the critics to rave about you and then mention that you collapsed during your curtain call.
Well, I don't care what it takes, Kelly, what I have to do. Nothing is going to stop me from being the dancer I know I can be.
But you're already a good dancer.
But good isn't enough. Good dancers are a dime a dozen. It's the great ones that get to do 8 shows a week.
And you got to be a great one, right?
The difference is commitment. That's why until I land my first big job, I'm not going to think about anything else except dancing and more dancing. Nothing is going to matter to me.
Well, I understand what you're saying, but there's more than one way to get there.
How?
Well, I want to be in show business just as much as you do, Jody.
And that's why you work so hard with your puppets.
Yeah, but puppeteering isn't everything. I mean, I also have time to care about other things.
Come on, better extension, better extension, Captain. Come on. Yeah, that's good. You can move a little more gracefully than that. Be with the linebacker for football team instead of the Joffrey Ballet, okay? Watch your back. Nice. Eyes up. Finish it out, ladies. Well, if it isn't Detective Stone.
Hey, how you doing, Wiley?
Look, none of these girls have boyfriends, so you don't have to worry about me beating up on anybody tonight.
Oh, yeah? Well, that's not why I'm here.
Oh, don't tell me that guy who was here decided to press charges.
No. Relax. Look, I'm off duty. My being here has nothing to do with police work at all.
Then to what do I owe the pleasure of a visit?
No special reason. I just thought I'd, walk over and check the place out.
Oh, that's right. You said something about being into dancing. Was it 5 minutes in here really whetted your appetite, huh?
Not exactly. I just thought it'd be fun to sort of, come check out a class, that's all.
You sure you don't have some secret desire to get back on the floor?
No, when I took lessons, it was a long time ago. I am strictly a spectator now.
Oh, come on, let me see what you can do.
Thank you, but no thank you.
Oh, you're not afraid of embarrassing yourself, are you?
Well, actually, the thought had occurred to me, yes.
You're not chicken. I mean, come on, take a shot. Let me see what you can do. Come on, I dare you, flat foot.
Okay. I'll show you who's got flat feet.
Girls, you want to give our visitor a little help?
Touch with a turn, huh? I'm in shape for all this. You still think I got flat feet?
You sure got guts, I'll give you that.
And that's all, huh?
How many lessons did you say take? Was it 1, 2?
Look, you have your floor show, so ease up, okay?
I mean, I know you said you were rusty. I took that into account.
Thanks.
But a little practice, you'll be one hell of a hoofer, flat foot.
Thank you, ladies. Wiley, I'll see you around.
Catch you later.
I didn't even find any dust.
I told you.
No, that doesn't mean you're in the clear.
But you could see with your own eyes that there's
just because there isn't a hint that the money is here only means that your hubby was too smart to keep any clues around.
Well, you're wrong.
Now, how do I know that there isn't a box full of cash buried out there in that front yard?
Why don't you just hire yourself a bulldozer then and dig the place up? You're not going to find...
Kirk owes me. Now, 10 years ago, we pulled that heist and he walked away with all the cash. 10 years, and he's been living high in the hog while the rest of us have been living like dogs. No more, lady. Now it's our turn.
I swear to you, you have the wrong man.
You have any idea what it's like to have that brass ring in your hand and lose it? That's what happened 10 years ago. The cops put out that phony report that Kirk Michaels was dead. We thought we'd lost that money forever. But now... Now that old Kirk's back from the dead.
No, Kirk is not back from the dead. The man you're holding is not Kirk Michaels.
Then why does he look like Kirk Michaels? And why does he sound like Kirk Michaels? And why does he say that he is Kirk Michaels?
Because I told him he was.
What?
It's a very complicated story. But you just have to believe me when I tell you that he doesn't know anything about the money. He doesn't know anything about the robbery because he was never there.
Look, I realize that you're desperate. To save your old man, honey. But there's only one way that you can do it.
I'll do anything I can. Just please be reasonable.
You got 24 hours to come up with some idea where that money is. And it had better be a very good idea.
What if I can't?
Then you better find yourself another husband.
Oh, please don't do this. I'm begging you.
And don't get talkative and decide to go talk to the cops. Because that'll only move the deadline up to immediate. Do you understand me? We'll be watching you.
But you'll be killing an innocent man. Don't you understand? And it's all for nothing.
It's not for nothing, Mrs. Michaels. It's called getting even. I'll be in touch.
Because of my dad's construction business, I've lived all over the world. I've lived in England, Morocco, Argentina. I can't even keep track of all the places I've been.
That must have been so exciting. What a life.
You think so, huh?
Oh, I'd love to travel. The closest I've ever gotten to Europe is the movies.
Well, the places that I've been were really nice to visit, but living there was a different story, at least for me.
Well, then you obviously didn't take advantage of museums and landmarks, shopping.
Well, that's great if you're a tourist. But day-to-day life wasn't much fun.
Yeah, I guess it could get boring after a while.
Well, half the countries I was in didn't even have schools that taught in English. So I had to have a private tutor.
That doesn't sound so bad.
Yeah, but it made it really difficult to meet people my own age. Although, it really didn't matter.
Well, why didn't it matter?
Well, because I was never in one place long enough to have any real friends. As soon as I got a pal, he became a pen pal.
So that's why you invented the pogo puppets?
Well, sure. But we speak the same language, and I can always take them with me.
I guess living in those exotic places isn't as wonderful as it sounds.
Well, my dad's in Italy right now. His contract calls for him to be in Rome for 5 years.
Oh, Kelly, Rome? And for 5 years? Well, you'll have plenty of time to make friends there.
You know, I was in Rome before I came to Monticello, and I'm not going back.
Not even for a vacation? You could live with your parents. It wouldn't cost you a lira.
I can't go back for anything. Not ever.
Kelly, what's the matter? Why don't you want to go back to Rome?
I don't know if I should tell you. I don't even know if I can.
Well, that's up to you.
Mike and Nancy don't even know why I left Rome. Really, why I ran away.
Something happened?
A few months ago in Rome, I got into some trouble. Some very heavy trouble.
You did? Well, I can't believe that.
Yeah, but it wasn't my fault. I wasn't responsible for what happened.
If you say so.
What Karen accused me of was wrong. I wasn't responsible for attacking her.
You said you attacked somebody?
And not anyone in the world believed me. Except for my folks. That's why I can't go back to Rome. Not ever.
I don't mean to interrupt, but dinner's ready.
Oh, we'll be there in a second, Dr. Gale.
Okay.
Well, we better go in the house now.
Jody, wait a minute. Now, you have to promise not to repeat that to anyone. No one. Please.